as Nils tickles your back of your head.
Am I entangled again?
Or am I? You're entangled again.
Fuck. Okay.
You're in.
I can't see anything, so I probably can't sacred flame anything either, right? Flame like radiance. Yeah, you can see within range.
You can point to a general location if you want to and try to sacred flame, but you already did. You had an action to break through your spider web. Well, you know what? We're doing movement on that. Yeah, you have an action you can do. So you can point by just holding left click and just give me a general vicinity where you want to shoot.
Okay, so for my action, I would like to light a torch and drop it on the square in front of me.
Okay.
Can I do that? Can I burn the...
You can do that.
Or from my square, whatever one will help me. It looks like the square in front
of me. So he doesn't have to... So he can free himself without doing an actual check?
That's correct. Yep.
What?
Yep. Mm-hmm. Fire on a web.
I used fire to free myself, but I also used my action to do so.
Uh-huh. Well, you're not burning the web section that you're on, right? You're burning the one in front of you.
He's going to drop it at his feet.
Yeah, I guess I'm going to drop it at my feet because...
I will allow it.
Because the one in front of me is done. So
from a torch.
Well, it's already... No, that's from the fireball. The one in front of me is clear from the fireball. That one.
Yes. So, but I was asking a fair question. You won't catch on fire because...
No, I'm holding.
Not from a torch.
You know, I'm like trying to push... Yeah. I'm trying to get rid of the cobwebs around me.
All right. So you drop it right there.
That's good.
I don't know how that affects Neil's vision, but you do drop it right there. The spider webs burn away, so you are no longer in Canton.
Hey, it's me, Joey. How you doing?
It probably doesn't make any light.
Playing some Dungeons and Dragons tonight.
No, it's got to be a magical light source to actually break through a darkness spell to have any light. So that's not. So it's not going to produce any light for it.
And a high-level lightness spell, right? Like, it can't be cantrip. It has to be...
It's got to be a spell of the same or higher level of the darkness spell.
Darkness is what? Second level, right? I think...
That's a good point.
I can't say it because that wouldn't... That's kind of meta.
I'm just thinking... I'm just trying to remember. Like, darkness... I think darkness is second level.
It is, too.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
Well... That's it for me then.
I'm good. Right,
so
good.
While technically, because you did that, you still have movement. You didn't burn up all your movement.
Oh, I didn't burn up all my movement? Mm-hmm. Then I'm coming up here by Sophia.
Okay.
Oh, that's the torch. Oh, that's Nil.
Yeah. Oh, there were three of you on that square.
Well, Nil, Fair is riding.
Yeah, Fair is on my back.
Oh, that's right. Yep.
Excellent. Yep. So as you break through the darkness, you notice a drow to your left, drow in front of you.
Here I am, stuck in the middle with you.
All right, I lift my shield, and that's the end of my turn.
All right, so they're both dual wielding short swords, and they just are zeroed in on you now.
Okay.
Right.
I'm alone out here, bitches. Better come on out.
One second. The turn order doesn't give me a good way of indicating which one is give it.
Oh,
so let's say...
They just use the same initiative. That's fine.
you have them both rolled, right?
Yeah.
If you hover over the turn order, they get a yellow square around them. So, like, the one, the red one is 5, right. And the blue one is 18. Yep.
You're right. Okay. Sweet. All right, so... I think.
Yeah.
And you notice...
Shield up, and that's my turn.
Yes. So you... As you shield up, you notice another one.
I can't see him.
He's now charging at you.
But I can't see him.
20.
Behind a dark.
Yeah, he's going to go right here. Two in the same square. Won't give him advantage, but he's going to come at you with a short sword multi-attack.
Hey. AC 20. Roll him high.
22.
Hold on to that sword. Hold on to that shield tight.
Go ahead. You hit me.
9.
Hey.
Here comes the second one.
Mm-hmm.
Right hand, left hand. That's a 9. That's a miss.
That's a miss.
All right.
Take that right on my shield. All right. 9 points of damage from the first attack.
All right. That brings in the king.
All right. I guess he's going to try to break free.
Okay.
I need to change. No.
Close. He struggles. Some webs break off, but not enough to set him free.
Does he has keen sense and smell and hearing? Does he at least hear the battle? Which direction the battle is?
Yes. In fact, everybody can. With this clanging the swords and stuff.
Bang, bang. Right on me.
All right. That's going to be his move.
Yeah. Okay. That goes back to Mrs. Featherbottom. You can hear clanging in the distance. Jennifer's sitting in front of you.
I hear my baboon whimpering.
Oh.
Hello.
He's whining. You can hear.
If you take the same spot where we are, it's only 2 strength rolls, but you don't know that.
You don't know that.
You don't know
hey
that.
Guys, it's welcome to the stream.
Crap. I have a hooded lantern. Can I use that to light the spot where he is on fire?
Question. Oh, is
on fire. Good.
Is Babu a Peanuts term?
It was a monkey from Aladdin. Babu.
No, I'm saying it's like a...
No, that's Abu.
That was Abu.
Oh, Abu. Sorry.
I don't know where I got it.
I'm thinking it's like the only time I've ever heard that is from that girl who talks about like her sweet Babu from Peanuts.
You're right. You're right.
That probably is her. Yeah.
She does say that. Yeah, Charles. It's the sister of Charlie Brown.
Oh no. Yeah, the other one.
Mm-hmm.
Shit.
That's a great trivia question there. I like that. So yes, if you throw your hooded lantern down on a spider web, it will break the lantern, and you will burn that 5-foot square.
You can get one shot. You got one shot. One opportunity.
Okay, I have an oil
to burn everything you could ever see in front of you.
I was trying to make
mom
come up with the
and mom spaghetti
to that song.
Yeah, right.
And mom spaghetti.
Mom spaghetti.
Can I use an oil flask instead?
Yeah.
And it won't burn him, or it will?
No, I wouldn't. I would. Yeah, no. It'll basically break whatever the spider webs are attached to, which is the ceiling, the wall, things of that nature. It'll engulf that. He could get enough to break free.
Okay. Then
but if you break the oil, you have to light it. Oil flask.
Still, yeah. I use your
is
item.
Does that take 2 turns?
It would use your action. Should use your action.
It should be 2 actions. Because you're using an action to throw the. Oh, I'll let the DM decide.
Gonna kind of round it up to one thing. So if you could make it kind of like a Molotov cocktail, you could stuff some fabric in here, light it, throw it. You could probably do that one action. I'll allow that. Being a little forgiving on that, but yeah.
Don't you dare tear a strip off my robes.
That's probably how I thought.
You don't have to. You don't have to roll anything like a dexterity to find out if they're fast enough without dropping it.
Yeah, we'll do something like that. But I'll give you a free roll to cut a piece of fabric off Kendra's robes with your dagger.
with
do I get a dex save or something?
It's like a sleight of hand or something.
How
like
about
that.
Sleight of hand. Sleight of hand against his perception. How about that?
My perception?
Okay. Well, if you notice, then you can swat away with a free action.
Good.
That's not too bad. It's only a 12. Oh, that was king. Never mind.
I'm just having a little fun with this turn.
Yeah.
I like it.
Take that.
You're not pretty good.
Take that, rogue.
Come on, sleight of hand.
So
he noticed.
Take that, rogue.
Let's be fair. I'm being a little frivolous with the rules on this, but he notices. He swats your blade.
I'm going to paint. I'm going to hot glue this and paint this.
That was so close.
Okay, well, I guess since I failed, I don't get my Molotov cocktail, so I guess that's my turn.
You can rip it off. You can rip it off your sleeve or something like that. So I was being a little frivolous with the rules, just to let the RP play out.
Yeah, so. I mean, I can hand you some of the cloth that I tore up to make the flaming arrows.
Okay, I'm going to pull out my red brand cloak.
Okay.
I'm going to use that to make it.
A little piece off of it.
Yep.
Interesting.
I thought we don't have any red band cloaks. I thought our red band cloaks disintegrated.
No. The enchantment didn't work in Thunder Tree.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Question is, when you ripping it, do you ruin the magic essence of it?
Probably. Well, I mean, if I can repair it magically, I could probably fix it.
All right.
My bevel is more important.
Yeah, I get it.
We're not thinking about that kind of stuff.
Got it. So right now that cloak is not going to have a magical feature, but go ahead, you rip it off. Stuff it in your flask. You light it. Woo! And you toss. So give me a... Go ahead, give me a dexterity. Bro, I don't want to do attack. Just kind of... You're trying to not hit your pet there. Your corgi. Easy enough. You got it right on his feet.
Dirty toss.
Yeah. Given the fact it's an oil flask, we can go basically in its... let's say 10-foot radius. So you burnt... if I can draw... Can I draw? Nah, I can't draw.
Could basically say that entire giant square.
Yeah, that's all. Has no longer has spiderwebs, so he's free.
The one that Nil is on as well is also empty.
Yes.
If you wanted to mark it, I don't know.
Okay, and. Sorry, I was just making the
note
of the cloak.
All good.
I was just making a Molotov cocktail. Give me a minute.
That's fine. It's fine. I'm going to say that probably took my action and my bonus action to do all that. So
okay.
And movement. So I'll be done.
All right. Now, as Imag looks up, a shadowy figure now becomes basically a drow elf sitting a little off from you, black robes and laughing. As soon as I get to the proper lair and drop his token where I need to go. You would think it's the first time I'm playing in roll 20. There you go. Say hello. To Nazirnar. This is Nazirnar, the black spider, as he eyes you up. What? Come fight with me. You don't have to die here today. He's looking at Imag.
Fight with you and I don't have to die? You're going to just lay down and let me kill you?
We work together. We have to clear this. We can help each other. We have to clear this mine out. There is a wraith of an old mage that protects the forge that I cannot get past. Us together, we are stronger. As I try to do my best not to be Darth Vader, quotes. Come to the dark side. What do you say?
I'm in the wrong character. I'm like, I want to detect
good or evil.
I got
it. Okay.
Welcome to the world
I'm
of multiple
I'm in the wrong
campaigns.
Character. Okay, can I just insight check him, I guess? I want to know.
Yes.
Like, because I want to know. All right, let me roll first, I guess. All
right, 19. Nice.
So I kind of want to know, like, is he actually bad? That's kind of where I really want to know.
So,
but I don't
as
think
Dom, as Dom asked, this is the boss fight. Yes, this is Nezernar, N-E-Z-Z-N-A-R, who is the Black Spider. He is the main catalyst of this entire module. This is the big baddie, and yes, you do pick up a sense of evilness from this guy. And you can tell he is lying through his teeth.
Oh,
he's,
okay.
He's basically going to use you for to clear the dungeon. I'm giving you a lot more information, probably picking up, but you can tell that he's just trying to use you.
Oh, yeah. Okay. So that, yeah, it was either he really wants us to help him keep something from coming, or he just wants us to maybe, or he'll betray us anyway. So it was either he's gonna betray you.
You got a little history of druid knowledge there too, is that they don't create alliances too easily. So you get a sense that there's something in his dungeon that he can't pass, and you probably need your help, so he's probably sincere there, but you just know as Drow that they will backstab you at the earliest convenience. Okay. Well, what's your answer?
Never.
Then you shall die.
Good luck.
I'm still trying not to do the Darth Vader thing.
Then you shall die.
Magic missile, first level. Coming at Imag.
Oh no.
A magic missile? That hits.
I would, I'll probably do, I'll be it doing a Minecraft hits. Stream pretty soon, probably.
Unless you have the shield that protects against magic missile.
I'll take those.
Our wizard
first
has
level.
That.
First level is only one dart, right?
First level is three darts. Whatever, it's a D4 plus one. So it's three of them. So that'd be six.
Six damage.
He reaches out his fingers.
No, no. Is it, okay, is it each missile a D4 plus one?
Yes, technically. Each missile is
or
a D4 plus one.
Okay.
Yeah, so you're throwing three missiles. Each one is a D4 plus one. Yeah.
Okay. All right. Yeah. What I was asking was, is it six or is it four?
It's six.
No, it's so the missile is a D4 plus one, kind of like a dart is a D4. So the missile itself is a D4 plus one, so it's D4 plus one times three. You can do it one of two ways. You can either do a D4 times three, or you can do three D4s plus three. So,
I meant
you got lucky. You got lucky. You got six, which is like the bare minimum.
Yep, got it. Cool.
Very cool. So we'll move on.
Get out here, folks.
As this would have vanished now, multi attack on poor iMac.
Got it, buddy.
Dread Warrior. Dual wielding. Incoming.
Roll high.
13.
That's not high enough.
Second hand. 17.
Also not high enough.
Okay. All right now. That brings it to Farag.
That's good. I need the safe. It's fine.
I'm on the back of the spider.
So
I think he's holding his turn, I think, until I finish my turn.
I believe I was preparing to jump off the spider's back once he gets within range.
Hey, you know what? I just forgot something. I had advantage on those two rolls. We'll let it go.
Why?
So,
why does he get advantage?
He's flanked.
But isn't
no,
only
he's not.
He's not flanked
no,
by
not.
Enemies.
Yeah,
he's flanked by an ally.
But I thought
that's not a flank.
You got to be on the complete opposite side.
Yeah, you gotta
for
be on
Sophia,
the opposite
that
side.
Would be flanked for the blue guy.
Yeah. Okay.
Right? That's a flank.
I thought it was more of adjacent.
No, it's no. From
unless
it's one
Sophia.
On the other side.
That the only thing that would do the only thing that would do is if they had sneak attack, that would give them sneak attack.
Yes.
Okay. 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 All right. Sorry, Bear.
It's cool.
So pretty much is that as Neil said, is that pretty much I'm just holding my action until he gets within range of the
we're clear of the darkness, pretty much.
Yep, pretty much.
Okay.
So,
all right.
Yep. So pretty much for me, it's probably just gonna be me casting spells, but okay. Jumping off the spider's back. So that's it.
Okay. All right. So that brings it to Kendroth, the bumbling Merlin.
The wizardy wizard. I'm going to the first thing I'm going to do is grab the glass staff and say Phandelver and cast mage armor on myself.
Okay.
And then I am going to try to make my way through the darkness straight ahead, my full distance, which is going to bring me just to the darkness square behind Bully.
All right, so you got two entanglement checks with the spider web that's there.
So you want what, strength saves?
Yes.
Okay, 18.
Cleared first one.
And a nat 20, baby.
Ooh, you cleared a second one as you ran into Nilmurg as a spider form and bomb biome right behind Imag. I got all these names.
You ran right underneath me.
All right, and that is it for me. I'm still in darkness.
All right, I bring
brings it to Nilmurg.
All right. Grab the stupid torch. I'm gonna move over this way, and of course, Fair's over here with me as well.
Mm-hmm.
We are clear, and we look up, and we see guys surrounding Imag. So
yes.
I'm going to go after blue guy, obviously.
Okay.
One second here.
All that turd.
Oh, wait, and so we would be at advantage.
Yes.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
So here's the first one. I'm glad I have advantage.
Yep, that's good. That didn't really help, though.
So both your bites, he was able to dance his way out of there since the drow are so agile, especially drow fighters. You're getting a sense that this guy's an elite fighter.
Okay, and...
Excuse me, I'm sorry.
And since I didn't do this... I just want to do this real quick. The my web recharge.
Yeah, okay.
And get it. Wow, my rolls are bad right now. Hopefully that stops.
You using Fortis's dice?
No doubt. Think I lent him to him. Just because. Yeah.
Yeah, I uploaded his dice into my roll 20, and apparently that was the wrong dice to upload.
I told him Sora wasn't playing, so.
But, That ends my turn. So right. Now I get Ferris up so he can slide off my back and do whatever he wants to do.
All right. So this brings it to the great and powerful and mighty Sophia.
I thought it was going to be Ferris.
Yeah, it's Ferris.
Well, you're...
It's Ferris' turn.
You're right.
He was holding his
action until I got us out of the shadow.
Okay. Yep. So he has one action.
Did I lose my bonus action?
It's technically not your turn, so you just held your action, which you wanted to cast spells. That's all you got. So as soon as you saw, let's say, a drow, then the spell you prepared, you can release.
Okay. So from there, I'm going to do didn't someone get hurt really bad?
Yeah, I'm hurt really bad.
Mm-hmm. Okay. how much life are you lost?
I have lost... Almost 30. 24.
Okay. Let's see.
I have 72, but I mean, my max is 72. I'm at 46.
Keep in mind, next time we're going to hold actions, you have to declare what you're holding so it goes off.
Uh-huh. Well, I'm... Let's see. I just want to do a
It's okay if you want
to. I want to do a.
Well, that's what I mean. If he's.
I can survive another turn, probably.
No,
that's what I mean. If he was holding a
prayer of healing.
Well, that's what I mean. If you're holding to attack something, you cannot heal. Because this is not technically your turn. You were holding the initial action that your spell you prepared. Something happened in between that caused you want to change up to heal, you cannot do. I'll allow it now.
If I can't do that, then I won't do it. You know.
Fair. I never called you to declare anything, so that's why I'll let you have it. But just going forward,
I will attack. Can I attack from the back of the spider?
Can.
Yes.
Okay.
Gotta make a rider check.
I'll make
a rider check.
Hey, what?
You gotta make a rider's check. What's it called? Animal rider or animal handling check.
Yeah, like a mounted check.
Mounted.
Yeah. It's mounted to attack.
Is it animal handling then?
Yeah, I think it's animal handling.
I can check what mine says. Yeah, a DC 10 animal handling.
So what happens there is you try to attack with your hammer and you do slip off.
I slip off the spider?
You slip off the spider. I won't put you prone, but you got down. You're off the spider.
Okay. Where am I?
You can follow through the attack.
We'll just say I moved. Okay, I was just trying to move myself so we could get you uncovered.
Okay, I'm right there.
So this time I'll let you slip off the spider, and as you're doing it, you're coming through with your hammer, so you still can get an attack.
Okay. Attack is action or hammer. Oh,
nice,
nice hit.
So I'm gonna. Since I did roll off, I'm guessing that my advantage just dissipated. Correct?
Yeah. It would be normal.
Okay. So there. There you go.
Okay. 9.
And I smack him with my hammer.
Blue. All right, you come down, slipping off the spider, but you come down and with a crushing blow on his shoulder, and he shrugs it off. And now...
He shrugs. Shrug? Is that the right word?
He shrugs. So now it's Sophia.
All right, so she's barreling through all this still. She's still blind, so she's going to continue straight. Is this considered out?
Yep, you're out.
Cool.
And as you look to your left, you're like, you see Imag, who's huddled up, bleeding, and these drow, and you see what you see. You get the two drows surrounding him. You got this drow wizard. Wizard.
I'll take a swing at orange. I think that's orange. All right.
Yep, so there's two there. So there's orange and a red, I believe, but yes.
You said orange and red?
Yeah, they're on top of each other.
They're
standing in the same space. Yeah.
I was thinking to myself, I know I'm colorblind, but
yeah, no. He placed them both in the same square.
I was mentioning there was two there.
Okay. So did we determine that if Imag is here, I have to be directly across from him for it to be flanking?
Yes.
Or is 120 degrees?
Yep.
Gotta be directly, across. So 180. 180 degrees.
Only. Okay. If I move over, am I going to be prone to?
No, you're still in melee range.
You still have plenty of movement. So.
Yeah,
just can't move away from him. You can move within.
Yeah, once you're in melee, you can walk all the way around him. You just can't leave melee range.
Oh, okay.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Gotcha. All right, so I'll move there.
All right.
And seeing my buddy bleeding, I'll attack orange here. With my cat's in a piano.
All right, I gotta get that sword out for you.
I know, I love. I thought that was pretty awesome.
That is awesome.
That's really cool.
It's called the Grim Cat, by the way. Just give credit.
I love it.
Nice. So as you come down with your warhammer, unfortunately, with his reaction, he turns around, pulls up both his blades to parry, you off. No hit.
A 9? Jeez, 19, no hit. Ouch.
Notice the key word, reaction parry.
That is true. Okay. All right, okay. Well, I'll swing again.
Okay.
He's already used his reaction.
Yeah. Eight. Okay. Yeah. So he parries the one blow, and you reach back for another, but yeah, he sidestepped it.
Oof. I wasn't saying that for the DM. I was saying that loud
you do
for the party.
Mm-hmm. Sophia's playing whack-a-mole with the drone. All right, so that's your turn?
Yeah, and I'll stand.
Okay. So, this is one quick second. Yep. It is... Now, it's the red guy. So, as he's dodging, the red guy tries to intermingle with the orange and try to, basically as a distraction, he's going to come in with a double blade on you.
Uh-oh.
Sophia.
Red doesn't like dwarves. For some reason, dwarves don't attack me. Or, I mean, Dro don't attack a dwarf.
18?
I don't know why.
Nope.
Okay. So, offhand. Here it comes. 19.
No.
Wow. So, ting, ting, off your armor.
Nice.
That brings it to Imag. Guys. Guys. Hi. Oh, hi, guys.
Okay.
Hello.
All right. So there's enough of you guys here, right? Right? You're all gonna be safe if I do some crazy movement stuff.
Remember, you can speak free action. You can talk to one another.
Yeah, I know, but that was table. That was table. Okay.
I'm total ready for whirlwind attack.
Okay. So,
helicopter attack.
What I'm going to do is I'm going to move and use evasive footwork, which means I can expend one superiority die, rolling the die, adding the number you roll to your AC until you stop moving. Currently, because I still have my shield up, my AC is 20, so I gotta roll a D8. That sucked. 21. All right, so I'm at 21, and I'm gonna move to there.
So how'd you make that? So how? What was your path to get there?
Well, I mean, can I go
here? Here.
Like, oh, here. Here.
Okay, fair. Okay. Here. So you get three opportunity attacks if you want to go there.
Two. One of those already used their reaction.
It's top of the turn.
We're top of the order.
Yeah, but it's
but
not.
They don't
his
get
turn.
It until it's their turn again. They only get one.
Oh, that's
reaction
true. That's true. They don't
until their
yeah,
next
true.
Turn. So.
So I get two of them, and my AC is 21.
All right. So here we go.
Go ahead.
Let's say the orange did the parry, so that's red guy. Oof. A natural one.
Nice.
I like
as
it.
He can almost
he, can he hit the guy he's standing in place with? just you know, out of help.
Yeah, parry this bitch.
He parries okay, so parries into his friend and knocks him prone.
Yeah, so they're all facing Sophia, and Imag tries to bolt. So he comes around with a kind of a left-hand strike, but fortunately his other partner was there, and he kind of elbows him in the jaw. I'll give him 1d6 damage for the elbow.
It's a heck of a fine elbow.
Yeah.
Oh, nice.
Oh, nice.
Cross-checked him. Ooh, so that would be red against orange, so takes...
Parry that, bitch.
Yeah. So now he's bleeding from the nose. And now, Blue saw him bolt, and he's going to try to hit him with a short sword on his way out.
Mm-hmm.
21.
Oh, fine.
And I should have been doing this from the get-go, but it has a poison damage because this one's laced. So it's 7 damage on the blue guy, plus... ...10. So 17 total.
Jesus shit! Okay. That sucked real bad. Don't do that again.
Wait, isn't poison a constitution check, though?
It says poison damage. It has a piercing damage plus the dice roll for poison damage.
I think it has initial damage, but you can have...
But, because poison should usually have a constitution saving throw to it.
Yeah.
It's not a poison condition. It's,
It's an effect on a weapon.
It's kind of like acid, I guess.
Yeah, it's like an effect on a weapon.
That just sucked real
poison
bad.
Poison weapon.
I'm just, saying.
We tried.
It's okay. So I am going to, with my first attack, I am going to cast Guiding Bolt on Wizard Face.
Okay. Guiding Bolt on Wizard Witty's face. Okay. Hits. I was trying to see if I can negate it. Go ahead.
Nice.
13 damage.
Ooh. As he screams in horror pain from the guiding bolt.
Poof. Okay. And then I'm going to use my second half of that attack to hit with the Winter's Dark Bite.
Okay.
And that's 19.
Guiding Bolt gives you advantage on that attack, doesn't it?
Oh, yeah, it does.
Let me roll advantage.
I need to... Hold on. That's not advantage.
Yep. So, as the Guiding Bolt crashes into him and you get ready to pull back for the Winter's Bite attack, he says a quick word at a reaction and casts his shield.
Can I precision attack and add a superiority die to my...
Get it.
That's a d8, adding a d8 to my attack roll.
Did you have to declare it first?
No, it doesn't say it.
Oh, it didn't help.
Okay. When you make a weapon attack roll, you can expend one superiority die to add it to the roll before or after the roll, but before any effects are applied.
Nah, you're good, man. I love the strategy. I love the strategy.
Okay, but it didn't work.
It didn't work.
So my attack doesn't hit.
Nope.
Okay, action surge.
Come on.
Let's go.
Alright, this is Winter's Dark Bite.
Go, man. Fuck. Squish that spider.
As you swing, he sidesteps.
No, it's okay. Second attack.
Okay. He sideswept, but you backhand him on the way up, and you got him.
Nice. Hit him.
Okay. Hit it. 2d6 plus 3. 10 damage.
You gashed him pretty good, man. He's bleeding from his chest profusely now.
That's only 23 damage that turn. Only. It's fine.
You took 22 damage?
Say what? I only did 23.
How many attacks was that from you, Imag?
Four.
Now you're starting to get the idea what fighters can do. They're just constant attacking.
Let me just shoots shit out of you.
And he shoots glowing bolts. Well, we can change your feet too, man. I was going to mention that in the Discord that I have no problem reversing your feet if you think you made a mistake there.
Nah, I'm going to use it today, so it's okay.
Okay. Is that it? Imag? Saving the party?
I'm done with this turn, but I definitely need some healing. Shield's still up, right?
Shield's still up. Okay. And that brings it to, I believe this guy is the orange guy. Yes. Steps. He does a ballerina step and melee behind Sophia for an advantage. Dual wield.
Dang, they're really trying to kill off Sophia.
That's a 12 on the first one. Both main hands miss. It's offhand.
Heck yeah.
24 on the offhand. With the and an advantage roll is a 22.
That hits.
Nine damage, and he did not coat his weapon with poison yet.
Lucky you. Right. That's a. It really hurt.
I'm happy with that.
Just so you know, that really hurt. Did I use? I used my action surge. I clicked that.
All right, I brings it to King.
Two superiority dice.
Back to the bow wow.
Honestly, I really wish I went before King. I wish it was the other way around. Because King has a plus +4 to strength, and I have a goose egg.
Thanks for the host, Dom. Thank you.
Yay.
But King is free. He's not entangled anymore.
And
we'll give him, because of the torch, and yeah, he's basically got two more to go straight. Or you can come out to the side. That's up to you.
I think
get in here.
King is going to be a sweet baby boy and wait for me.
Okay. Which brings it to Mrs. Featherbottom with sounds of combat, and you hear this unfamiliar voice. Well, a familiar voice that you heard before is screaming, bleeding from his chest, but you can't see the bleeding, but you definitely know he's in horror pain.
Okay.
That familiar.
So I did a little research on having mount, and I'm not 100% on it, but I'm pretty sure he would count as an independent mount, not like a horse.
I'll agree with that.
Means that he can attack.
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah. Yes. Oh yeah.
I'm mounted.
Yeah,
but
my whole.
It also means I don't get to move on my turn. I have to wait for his turn, right?
Yes.
Okay, that's what I thought.
Yeah, it's like a mounted combat.
So I will use, I guess, the half movement to get on mount onto him, and I don't want to hit anybody, so I will. I guess that'd be it.
All right. Did you? I mean, I know you didn't say it, but you said that King was gonna. What, hold his action? He was going to wait for you?
Yeah.
You
well,
said
no,
wait for you, yeah.
Yeah, but he can't take any movement, and there's not really any action he can do back
well,
here.
Well, the only action he could take would be dash.
Yeah, but no, he's an independent mount.
Right.
Okay.
So, I guess
enough.
Technically you're right. He can hold his action to move as a dash. You're right.
He could wait for you to mount him and dash.
Try to get in here.
Right.
I mean, not trying to meta it too much, but you know, if you were just waiting to move him until you got on him.
Yeah.
You know.
Yeah.
No, you're fired with the meta stuff. It's a new homebrew thing we have, and it's a mounted combat. Heck, I'm not even familiar with that, so I don't mind a little discussion with rules.
Fine. Yeah, I tried to do a little bit of research.
I was about
on
to mention the same
battle.
Thing, you know, because mm-hmm. it makes sense that, you know, he's holding mm-hmm. his action for her to get on and then to move mm-hmm. after that.
Yeah, yeah. Oh yeah, please don't be afraid of meting. That's we're just trying. We're all trying to figure out rules, and that's mounted combat. That's kind of almost advanced play.
So he gets it. That means he would get like one normal movement, right?
Yes, correct.
Okay, and it's half because of the icky, right?
There's only two obstructed spaces between him and me, right?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, going straight. Yeah.
We'd have to roll two checks.
Okay, so I will, I guess, try to move. Yeah, that would be about where he could make it to. So two strength checks from him. Mm-hmm. Come on, baby. Come on, baby. Do mama good.
13 is your number.
Nice.
Oh, yay.
Nice.
There's one.
That's one.
More.
Nice.
Okay, one more. Come on, baby. Come on.
Let's go, King. Let's go, King.
Nice.
Got it. See, there's a situation where the dice says it's on 10, but it says 14.
Yep.
You plus 4. Nice.
He's a strong baby.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, then that will be it for me then.
Okay. As Nazir stands up in front of Imag, bleeding from his chest, he looks down his chest, looks at Imag, and it looks deep into his eyes. Roll me a...
I know I'm strong in constitution.
I think it's a charisma check for a charm spell.
Probably.
I believe charisma check.
Yeah.
Yeah, charisma save. Yep.
Oh, mm-hmm. charisma save? I'll take a save.
Mm-hmm.
That wasn't probably all that
good. Oh, no.
So, fortunately, 13 was a number. So, as he whispers to you, kill Sophia. She stole your flask. No. Now you are under a suggestion spell, which means you have to follow up those orders.
Got it, dude.
Sounds like an evil Bill and Ted.
For like 8 hours.
Really?
For 8 hours, your target is
we
Sophia.
We have to knock him out and tie him up just like last time?
If he takes damage, he has to roll to save again. All right, so with that... I can't roll a cantrip as a bonus, so... That's it. And this guy is the blue guy.
Oh, this says, so charm person as a spell is a wisdom save.
Is it a wisdom save?
Yeah.
Give me a wisdom out of fairness.
Reroll.
I mean, it is, it's, okay. I'm just going to shut up.
No arguing. Just do.
Yeah, the charm person is a wisdom save.
Oh, no.
So.
I mean, I guess.
So as he whispers these things, you kind of go, okay, my flask is right here. Doesn't affect you.
I was so ready to punch you in the face, too.
You are so lucky. I would just unload. I was just going to unload. It's not good. It would not have been good. Because I'd have RP'd that. I would have RP'd that.
Oh, yeah.
But
that's the way you would have had to need to do it.
Yeah.
Yeah, exactly.
So I would unload. It wouldn't have been fun.
Yeah, I didn't mean for you to reverse that, Avalar. I was just letting you know that it was a wisdom save on the spell. So,
well, it's a plus one versus a plus three, so it's only fair, especially it's pretty detrimental that he's gonna go after Sophia. That it play out that way properly. It's all right. You killed my big baddie. It's okay. Probably like I used that action. Is it action? Now what am I gonna do now? Mm.
Remember, the bad guys are here to be beaten, Avalar.
I know, but I'm trying. I'm playing.
It is your goal to make it as hard as possible on us.
It is. He's the big baddie, man. It's got to be worse on.
It's fine.
All right. Well, I'm out. I can't. I don't have an. I can move out, but I gotta. Nope.
You. All right. Yeah, so it's the. You get an opportunity to.
It's the blue guys. So it's the blue guy who turns on Farrah. Both are coated with poison, by the way. Who is now gonna come after him?
No, I blow him a kiss.
All right. Ooh, it's almost a natural 20. Mid hand. Off hand. 18. It is not hit. I whispered to myself.
Oh.
And. That is it with that. It's fair actor.
Oh no. Let's see. Are any of these guys damaged right now?
Yep.
Which one is damaged the most?
The guy in front of you is you can see from his armor that he was attacked previously.
Okay, so the blue guy is the one that's taking the most damage, correct?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So let's see what the maximum amount of damage I can do to something. Spells. Inflict wounds at the third level. And I'm giving him the good old head shaker. So let's do that. And I still have advantage, correct? Or do I have advantage now or no? No?
No.
Okay.
No, because you'll have someone that's at, you know, the 180 for him, so.
Okay.
All right, so you reach out to do your tickle, and he sidesteps. You miss. You can't grab him.
Okay. Let's see here. The tickle's gone. And let's see. Zero. No bonus action. Okay, from there I'm is there anything I can do? I don't think so, because they're all spells.
Mm-hmm.
So, I'm going to shield up. That's it.
Okay. So that brings it to Kendral.
Okay. So, hearing all of the sword play in front of me, I'm just going to step forward.
Okay.
And then seeing these two drow.
Three drow total, but yes.
Well, yeah, but I see two. I walked right into the middle of two of them. Right, so seeing two of them, I am going to cast Thunder Wave. So I'm going to stomp my foot and say, Dalsin, and they need to roll a con save of 14.
Okay. Pull that up.
Do-do-do-do. So it's everyone within 5 feet of me, but using Sculpt Spell, I can make Farrah save his throw and not take any damage. Save his make his save. So it's just the two drow.
Okay. 19 for the blue.
Okay. So he's good.
And red is 6.
6. So he's gonna take 10 thunder damage.
Ooh. As you come down and crash and rock, as he was, I think he was facing Sophia. I'm not sure how to react.
And
that,
he's so all right. So on a failed save, he takes 2d8 thunder damage and is pushed 10 feet away from me.
10 foot through Sophia.
Yep. On a successful save, they take half, but isn't pushed. So the blue one takes half. So the blue one would take 5.
Okay. So the question I have is, If I go forward, does he knock Sophia?
That's up to you. He gets pushed 10 feet away from me. Which technically would be Sophia's square, right?
So this would basically play in... this is almost a push thing. So... let's play... man, I don't know how to do this one. It's basically a dexterity from Sophia that she's going to sidestep this and let him continue forward against his dex. How about that?
I would say either do a dex or you could possibly strength to just, you know, be able to stand upright.
Yeah, I don't think his role has anything to do with it. I think it's going to be more her acrobatics or athletics to get out of the way. Because so he's being forcibly pushed 10 feet. So
fair. So I'm going to set this number at 15 because what I'm seeing happening is that it's the push. He's going to bounce into Sophia and bounce prone. Question is, does he actually go 10 feet because Sophia's in the way? So if she can sidestep with a dex, let's say 15, because she didn't know you were going to do that.
Right.
So let's do that. That's the fairest way I can play that.
So I'm going to do a dex saving.
Yep. What's your bonus there?
Zero.
Yeah, saving. It's a check more than a save.
Oh, okay. Let me find dex. There it is.
Is it negative two?
It's negative one.
Oof.
Yeah, no.
All right, so that plays out.
It was happening.
The drug is pushed, and you bounce off your plate armor there, crush himself, and falls down prone. So he is prone. We'll do it that way.
In position. So he's still in the same spot, but prone. Okay.
Prone, yeah.
I'm prone?
Interesting.
No. The drow.
Oh, did I mark you by mistake?
No. No, he thought you said Farrah is prone. He said that's the fairest way I can play it, is what he said.
Oh, I got you.
I can see it.
All right. So, I'm assuming that's it?
Yeah, that's it for me.
All right. So, that brings it to Nilmer.
All right. Nilmer's about to have some fun.
Okay.
Bonus action to transform back to my halfling form, so I'm no longer a spider.
Okay.
And this spell is going to be getting dropped right on blue.
Okay. Uh-oh. When he says dropped,
I just dropped a flaming sphere right on top of blue.
Okay.
DC 16 dexterity takes the fire damage. If he makes it, then he takes half, so he'll take 3. So it's either going to be 3 or 7.
Oh, 10!
Okay, and then I'm rolling it diagonally, because I can still move it,
okay,
into red.
All right, so he's got disadvantage there.
He's going to be at disadvantage.
What was the damage?
7 fire. So blue's gonna take 3.
That's crazy. It can be moved?
Yes, it can.
Yeah.
How long?
You said 3's damage?
Yeah, 3's the damage for blue, because it's normally 7, okay, but since it was half, you know, rounded down.
So he's gonna get this. Blue's gonna get, or orange is gonna, red is gonna get disadvantage on this roll. So that's one roll, a 9, and the second roll. 8. So he's full damage, I believe.
Yeah, so that'll be 7.
Okay. All right.
That ends my turn, and it's sitting on red right now.
I didn't see any of that. I'm looking the other way.
Nice. That's a minute.
That is a minute. Nice.
Jesus. Does he take damage at the beginning and end of his turn?
If he's still in the spot, then yeah, he takes damage again at the end of his turn.
At the end of his turn? Okay.
Yeah.
Yep.
Ahead.
Any creature that ends its turn within 5 feet of the sphere must make a dexterity saving throw.
Oh, geez, you guys all gotta move.
Oh, crap, yep.
You mean he can't save me from it?
He doesn't have spell sculpting. Y'all gotta move.
Yeah, it's not an evocation spell. It's conjuration.
Is it concentration?
Yeah, it's a concentration spell, yes.
You could let it out then.
Except I could use it every single turn to have it chase down people.
Yeah.
That's true.
It's like a spiritual weapon.
Yep, basically. Mm-hmm.
All right, it's Sophia's. This big old ball flame that's in front of you now.
I'd probably do that like. You're a madman. You're a madman.
Right? I'm sorry, what?
Am I without I'm out of that range, right?
It's a 5-foot ball, but if you end your turn within 5 feet of it, you need to make a dex save.
Oh, okay. So I'm good where I'm at.
No.
No, it's what's on it? Red, so you're at 5 feet,
on,
so you're gonna have
blue.
No, it's no, on it, no, it hit blue and then rolled to red.
Rolled to red.
Oh, I missed that part.
So I hit both of them with it.
It hasn't been their turn yet, so they don't have a reaction. You can move.
Yeah, well, woo-hoo! I'm going to...
Thanks, buddy.
Right?
Yeah, I'm going to see ready. Imag over here trying to kill the big baddie, and she's jealous. She ain't going to let him have that. she's going to hop over right here. And just totally ignoring this guy, because like all she felt was like a couple tings. You know, she got a little scratch that's... from it, but she's not too mad about it.
Yeah, technically... Okay, so that's definitely an opportunity attack.
I'm still within his range.
She didn't leave his range, and he's prone. So,
yep.
Yeah, fair. Okay. I was questioning that diagonal is okay.
All right. So I'm gonna swing at him with my cats and a piano.
Okay.
On who? The spider? Meow. Hit him! Get him!
On the spider.
Cat on the spider.
Nice.
Remember, so he still has shield up. So that is.
Yeah, he does.
Yeah, as you come down, you crackle against the magical ore that's around.
Okay, I'll swing one more time.
Okay.
That probably.
And you got it. So yeah, all the force energy you got in as the force energy went up, you came under. If they could play it that way.
Nice.
I'll very nice.
It. And then so I like wanna... axe insert. Oh, well, wait, what?
What? How you want to do it?
That's funny.
Ice.
Nose to anus, slice down.
Wow. As he split in half.
Disemboweled.
Doom. And with that.
And with pure disrespect. I'd like the accent surge and just try to kill Orange.
As the blade rings, meow.
Meow.
You know, what's the gif of Neil deGrasse Tyson where he's like pointing across? Meow. Meow.
Meow. I sit down on TikTok video to bully the.
Oh, the stop sign. Yeah, it's great. Oh. Yeah.
And now as he spins around to Orange, all he hears is the axe hissing.
Yes.
Yeah, maybe it's an anger. I like that.
All right.
You
so
guys
going after Orange.
We're supposed to keep him alive, so we can interrogate.
It was nose to anus, no lethal.
Wow.
So you try to come around for an extra attack. Orange saw it coming and undone. Oh, you got advantage?
Well, no. He action surge. He gets both his attacks.
Yeah, I get both my attacks still.
Okay, so the first one he ducks, but as he was coming back up, you hit.
Ooh,
that's a big hit.
It is a big hit.
Nice.
One damage.
I'm sorry, what?
That's my max.
Yeah,
max.
Awesome.
So yeah, he took a pretty big gash on his right side, but he is still ready to fight. Joe's been through this, and as he laughs at you, I had worse for my sisters.
Just cleaved off a leg, but you know.
Only a flesh wound.
What? You're going through his armor. And he's trained in the most horrific society ever.
Fair.
as he spits,
he
my younger sister
just peel apart in half. Just
yeah.
Before
my younger sister hits. My younger sister hits worse than you. All right.
Okie dokie.
Back to my turn order. And speaking, it's actually red, so he's got to use his. That's how we're doing it, right? Movement to come out of prone. He's in fire, so he takes damage on his beginning of the turn.
End of his turn, if he doesn't move at least, he's got to move at least anything that's within 5 feet. So he's got to move at least 10 feet away to, you know, not take any type of damage to end his turn.
Yeah. Okay. And half movement to get up.
All right, so real quick, this ends. This effect ends. I got so much stuff on my screen.
Oh, cool. Darkness is down.
The darkness is down. All right.
And this is when you hear the voice from behind you go, "You were supposed to keep him alive."
Thinking about strategies. So he is going to.
I thought of something mean to say. You were supposed to help.
What are the odds that I'm going to have something nasty to say to me, huh? Huh?
Uh-huh. Oh, let's see. He's going to cast Levitate.
Red is.
So he's going to float 20 feet above the air, above the fireball. And I have to, give him something.
He's flying.
He's not actually flying, so he's just levitating, so.
Yeah.
Huge difference.
Well, there is, because he doesn't have any lateral movement. He can only levitate.
Yep.
So as he
stands up in his fireball, he raises himself up, pulls out a hand crossbow that is coated, by the way, and is going to shoot at Kendroff. Thinking the fireball came from him.
Fair enough.
Sorry, buddy.
It's all right.
24. 24 to hit.
24 to hit.
I'm assuming that's not platinum.
Yeah, no, I'll take it. Best I can do is 22, so I'll take it.
Okay. Best I can do is 22.
And it is 5 damage.
Okay.
But you do now. This is where you gotta do a DC Constitution save or throw or be poisoned for 1 hour. The hand crossbow gives you this poison effect. The blades don't. So just FYI.
Okay.
So 16.
And you're not poisoned.
Cool.
If the saving throw fails. If you failed, you're unconscious while you're poisoned. Nice.
Ooh, so really?
Glad you passed that. All right. So that is... Red's turn, and you're right, it's a levitate spell. He can't move laterally, but he can come up and down. So he's above the fireball. Somebody needs to push him out of the way. Or fireball spell goes first. Okay. I'm at top of the turn. As Sophia just cleaved your target in half as a strange meow sound happened.
Okay. Meow. I am going to turn around and drop Winter's Dark Bite.
Okay.
And pull out the ivory hunting bow.
Okay.
And
All in slow motion. And like the last action hero.
And I'm going to shoot the floaty guy.
Okay.
With attack number one.
But Imag is the only one moving in slow motion, and the rest of us are looking at him like, why is he moving so slow?
As he pulls back, as he pulls back and lets, are you going for the special bow or just a regular shot?
Just a regular, the regular bow shot.
Arrow goes flying. As the drow turns to look, the arrow hits him right dead in the chest.
Nice.
With 8 damage.
8 damage. You would think an impact of the arrow with a floating guy can drift him along a little bit, but no, it don't work that way. It's like a hot air balloon, you know?
That's it.
Okay, so he has 8 damage.
Yep.
I'm just, is levitation a concentration spell?
Ah.
I believe it is.
It would be kind of cool if you fell 20 yeah. feet into a fireball.
It is not a concentration.
If I cast it is, but.
Oh.
I might be wrong with that.
Levitate is concentration for 10 minutes.
Diamond with the C on it. It is a concentration spell.
Yep.
So technically, he falls.
No, he has to make a check.
Concentration.
I don't know what that is. Probably wisdom or something.
It's against his. Yeah, it would be against his wisdom score, I think. Right, against his ability score, wisdom, I think.
It'd be a spell casting ability, but
that's it. Yeah,
it's charisma for drow. So.
Oh like, right, yeah, like yeah, yeah, yeah.
So okay. It's got to be wisdom to hold on. So let's see. Against my spell save, right?
Yeah, sure.
I believe so.
All right, it says 12 is the number. Ah! 10! Hey.
No!
Oh, you just crashed right down into a fireball.
2d6.
Not only that, it takes fall damage.
Oof!
I like it.
You not only that, it's only the first half of my attack.
Yes. Right, he re-entered it, so.
Okay, so.
You guys are messing this one drove. This poor drove. Up and down.
Knocked prone. He rises up. He comes back down.
At this point, you give us okay. the most piddliest like enemies, and they're going to destroy us. Give us bosses, and we're like,
This guy got knocked into Sophia, bounced off her chest, fell back down, got up from the fireball, fell back into the fireball. Okay. Nice. I love it, though. All right, so that was Imag, all in slow motion as he turns around like Ben Stiller.
And that was only one of his attacks.
Yeah, that was only one.
Okay.
What else you got up your sleeve?
I might as well... Can I shoot him again?
Sure. He's in the fire.
Not yet. That boy's hurting.
I forgot how to do that.
Is he prone on the ground?
Yeah, is he prone?
Yeah,
if he's prone, I don't want to.
Yeah, he's prone. He fell.
Okay, then I want to hit the orange guy.
All right.
26.
Nice. As you sniper to one guy and he falls, you turn your eyes on the orange, let the arrow fly, and it hits him square in the shoulder.
The arrow.
5 damage.
Arrow.
Nice.
As it goes in his shoulder, he pulls it out and laughs at you.
I'm sorry.
I don't like the laughing. I'm sorry.
Not gonna be laughing for long.
Wait, is it? No, that's my second. That's my second. And second win. 1d10 okay. plus 5.
Go. Which way are you going? Orange game?
No, second wind is healing.
Oh. I can always think second wind's like second wind. Like
I know, you would think it is, but yeah. No, that's healing. Yeah. Action surge is a second attack.
Alright, so I get...
That makes more sense too.
1d10 plus 5, so 10 health back to me.
Okay. Awesome. As you heal,
that's the end of my turn.
His silvery eyes are now beating red, looking dead at Imag.
Uh oh.
steps up.
Save me, Sophia.
Coming full in with the attack.
Alrighty. I got full no shield.
You will.
Got no shield.
26.
Yeah, that hits, I guess.
With or without shield.
Hester. 9.
Thanks. Offhand. I'm glad I had that second offhand.
23 for offhand.
23 hits.
Damn. 8.
Okay.
Hey, when you're nailed, it sticks out sometimes, you know.
It's, yeah, you're the
main,
all right.
Mage threat.
No worries.
All right. So it's King's turn. Dun, dun, dun.
All right. King can finally move. I guess he will. Ugh, I got hair in my mouth. I don't know. It's killing me. I've been trying to pull it out for like 3 minutes, I swear.
You were riding a coat free. It happens.
Okay. I guess we will run up here to this guy, and
okay.
Sweet that boo is going to bite him.
Okay.
Big old damage. Crud. 17.
It just does not get the initial bite as he was coming in through his armor.
Okay. He gets advantage. Flanked.
Oh, he does.
Correct.
Ooh,
that's correct. You're right.
This
and he also has pack tactics, which means he gets
he's a little surrounded
with anybody's 5 feet anyway. So,
look at that. You just get advantage all the time.
Nice.
Yeah. So the you bite.
Hey, if he bites,
big old corgi against a drow, I would say is probably half his shoulder.
Gotta make that DC 14.
Or get that's right.
That is right. That's
hey, a strength you made this thing.
I know. King is awesome.
I know. He's a CMD.
16, so I did save that. Is it half?
Or
no,
it was
no,
not prone. That's right.
Yeah,
that's right.
You took the full piercing. It's just the DC right. Is to keep standing.
Gotcha. So yeah, he took a big chunk out of his shoulder. He's all surrounded by you guys. He's bleeding pretty good, but he's got fight in him still, as a druid usually do. He ain't losing wind.
King with a mouthful of drow says, "Parry that, bitch."
Yeah. All right.
Mouthful of drow.
Mouthful of drow. All right. Mrs. Featherbottom.
Mrs. Featherbottom is going to get off of... Well, apparently I brought the torch with me. Is going to get off of the corgi so that she doesn't have to do a save.
Okay.
And she's going to stabby stabby.
Okay.
Nice.
So, and... Want to know what? I'm going to stay in this space so I get advantage.
In King space? Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Where are you? There you are. That's a good thing I had it.
Nice.
Oh, okay. Never mind. It was the first one. And then the dagger.
That's the full 21 with sneak attack. Nice.
Mm. Mm.
Not nice. So good.
That one is only going to be, what, the 4? Because don't get sneak attack.
Only 4 if it hits. I don't think a 13 hits, though.
Yeah.
The first one does not. The rapier... even if I did a parry, it's not going to... You stabby stabby on the rapier.
Nice.
For 21 damage. As you just, as King bit, he turns in anguish, and you just came in with the rapier across his half his back and his side, and you just gashed him. He falls. He's completely like, he's almost out of this fight.
And then I'm going to yell at Imag, and I'm like, oh, like that?
Yes, like that.
All right, so that's your end of your turn. So as he turns on Neela, half no, there.
Actually, I'm not done. I'm sorry. Have my bonus action.
Correct, you do.
And I'm disengaging. I'm gonna move behind Kindroth. Nope, right here. Behind Kindroth.
You don't want to be right there.
Yeah. There you go.
All right. So, and his last, I'm trying to speed up a little bit because it's 8 o'clock. As he's lashing out through his last moments, he's looking at the squishy target. As she watches the halfling take off behind the mage, he's going after the mage.
Thanks, Neela.
Sorry.
That's quite all right.
17.
17 does not hit. Oh, wait, 17 right. Hits with mage armor, but I'm going to slam the staff into the ground and say focal and cast shield. So that's going to put me to 22.
All right. That comes into his offhand as you pop your shield up for a natural one, which he loses his blade because he's half not, you know, he's half not coherent at the moment. He's down to one blade.
Oh boy.
That brings it to Farragher.
That means he takes he's gonna take 3d6 damage. He didn't move out within 5 feet.
That was the this is the blue guy.
Yeah, the blue guy's within. He's within five feet of the fireball.
Oh, we'll see. Okay.
So he's going to take. Well, he's got to roll. It's going to be a dexterity check.
He's going to make a dex save.
Yep, which is going to be. It's a DC 16.
That's 18.
Okay, so he's going to take 3.
All right.
So as is the guy bed?
No, not yet. As his radiant heat, as his radiant heat burns him, and he threw his sword, he's kind of like half dragging the last sword he has, looking to lash out at least one more time.
I was waiting. I want to see what he did because he was either going to take that, or if he moved away, a couple of people would get opportunity attacks no matter what direction he went.
I can't really technically. Well, I guess I can.
Well, you could move diagonally if you had to.
Yeah, but there's no matter what way he goes, there's at least 2 opportunity attacks.
So it is Farag, actually.
Uh-huh.
Your turn.
Can I use a bonus action to disengage and then attack?
No, you don't get disengage as a bonus. Only a rogue does.
Only rogues can do that.
Oh, okay.
You're gonna disengage action.
I'm gonna try one more time to hit. Now you said one of these drow's armor is crumbled, correct?
The blue.
Yeah, I flavor some attack, but yeah.
Okay, I'm just wondering if is the armor like a bonus to their AC?
No, their AC is their AC. That was more just for flavor.
Yeah, their AC isn't.
Okay.
I think it was on King trying to bite him.
I'm gonna try to level 3 tickle the other guy, the orange one.
Mm-hmm.
So let me go to spells. Last level 3 spell.
You're gonna tickle the orange.
Yep.
That means you have to move. It isn't inflict wounds. It's a touch spell, right?
Yeah, it's a touch. You have to move towards him.
Not orange, red.
Oh, red.
Thank you. Okay.
Red. Okay, you said orange, so... Right.
I'm colorblind.
He's in 5 feet. He takes fire damage too, right?
Only if he ends his turn there.
He can move after he...
Okay. Yeah.
Well, he's within... Okay.
It's at the end of his turn. That's why I didn't say anything for blue until you ended blue's turn.
Yeah, I thought it was a start. I'm starting thinking he's going to reach into this ball of fire and touch this guy.
Yeah. He also specifically states at the end of their turn.
Yeah, we did.
So... We're going to, and then roll.
I lost. Did I lose my stream?
Nice.
That hits. As you reach out.
Well, let's see the horrific damage then.
It's gonna be bad.
Nice.
Nice.
I don't think he's getting up from that one.
Ooh. Ooh.
Well, the way the other one laughs, I wouldn't be surprised.
Except this dude got beat a bit, he decided to levitate, he got sniped, and he crashing back down onto a fireball.
He wasn't good, so as you touch him, you literally, the crack damage absorbs his life essence as he shrinks and shrivels. He is dead.
I squeeze him, I wring him out like a rag. The dark hands come out, and they just grab him, grab his arms, lift him up into the air, and then wring him out like a rag. And then, yep, all that life comes out and disappears into the darkness.
Nice. I had a blip in my internet. It took a lot of things down. Even roll 20. Okay. So give me one second.
Sure, absolutely.
Yeah, I noticed that your stream had gone down. Or I thought it had gone down, and then I got the advert for Twitch, and I'm like, okay, well, here we'll wait 20
years. I'm going to move to, let's see here.
You can move like next.
One option.
Yeah, you can move literally just one spot to the left, and you're fine.
I'm going
to
move north.
Okay. So that's a attack of opportunity.
The blue again.
Yeah, that's fine. That's fine.
Wait, but you're still within 5 feet of the sphere.
Oh, yeah, that's true.
Yeah.
I am?
Yeah.
Yeah.
The fireball is still on the red guy.
Melee range, so you need to have.
Where's the sphere?
It's
on the red guy.
It's where the red is.
Then I want to move to right here.
Okay, so okay. Blue will still get an attack of opportunity.
Yep, go ahead. Attack away.
So as he tries to swing on his left, saving throw as you try to get away. With a natural one. So he throws a sword at you.
Again, and now he's swordless.
Yeah, I was gonna say now he has no weapons.
Yep, no weapons.
Oh, you guys know what to do then, right? Okay, as long as you guys know what to do.
All right, so that I'm assuming you're.
Good. I'm going to go ahead Kendra's turn.
I'm here.
I'm gonna go ahead and.
I'm glad you're here.
What? No, it's not worth it right at this moment. I'm gonna stay where I am at and shield up.
Okay. All right, that's Kendral's turn.
Okay, so blue is the only one left down by us. So by I am going to reach out with shocking grasp and grab him and say Haran Athazara.
Okay.
Gonna be a 21 to hit.
You have an advantage, 21. And you do hit as you reach out to shock him for 7 damage because he only had 1
7
left.
Lightning damage.
As he only had 1 left. How do you want to kill him?
I just want to grab him and just like make his eyes light up. And just, you know.
All right.
Until they explode.
Yeah, until they
so
like, pop like popcorn.
Like Raiden, as he lights up like Raiden from that's Mortal it. Kombat with his that's eyes exactly lighting up. Thinking. Shakes and... You want to burst?
No, that's fine. We can just right. smell roast drow hit the floor.
You smell roast drow as he sizzles on the floor.
Reminds me of home.
And King's smelling him.
King's just licking his chops.
Yeah, King's smelling him, thinking it's bacon strips.
And then I'm gonna step away from that fireball and say, "Turn that thing off, will you?"
And I say. I guess you don't know what I was saying. I guess you don't know what to do. Fine.
Who, me? What, you want me to come up here?
No. No, I was... I thought you guys were going to just knock him out.
Oh, we don't knock people out.
You still have orange right behind you.
Nobody rolls anymore.
Eviscerate and maim.
All right. Well, all right. It's Nil's turn.
There's Nil's turn.
All right. So, as my action, this is going, of course, to orange.
Yep.
Hi, the Roxbury.
Are you going to drop the concentration?
No, he's going to move it to orange.
Okay. Right, jeez, you're going to make us all move.
Here's a Toll of the Dead. DC 16 Wisdom for 15 necrotic.
Ooh, nice.
What a wisdom save. 16. Negative, a natural one.
So he just took 15 necrotic.
As his brain just crushes his skull. Okay.
I tell Nil to send the fireball down the hallway.
Wait, is he still alive or did that kill him?
No, it didn't kill him.
It didn't kill him?
Nope.
It crushed his skull.
the ring. Come on, guys. He don't crush his skull. They're ringing in his head. He's like, but as the fades out.
Okay.
The flaming sphere just rolls right into him.
Okay.
That's going to be DC 16 dexterity. And
here you bowling with a ball of fire. Kendra's jealous.
You got to love druids.
23.
Okay, so he takes 6.
Okay. He's able to get out a little bit, like jump over, but he gets sizzled a little bit. As he comes down, looking all mean, ready to attack the first thing he sees that's the weakest target at the moment.
And that ends my turn.
Okay, so that brings us to Sophia. That incredible axe of hers.
Kill him, kill him, kill him, kill him.
She's going to pivot. Over here.
Okay. I like your pivot as you bounce behind him. Are we square dancing?
We are. You don't hear the music?
Only when the fat lady sings.
It was a big bell that just rang.
Okay. As he swings... With his reaction, he parries the axe. Ding. Off your 20. Parries that too. Well, he can't parry again, but it boosts up to 3.
Rip.
Wait. It's only for the one. So is a reaction parry, is that for the one attack or for the rest of the turn?
It's for the rest of his turn. Attack.
Oh, it is? Okay.
A reaction, you get one reaction per turn.
Right, but does the effect of parry last?
Oh no, it's only the one attack. No,
it's
instantaneous. So it's just the one attack.
That's what I thought.
So the second round, as she comes back through with the axe, does make contact.
Nice. Hit. Dang it! I hate when I roll threes. I'd rather roll a 1 or a 2.
I just
want to
re-roll it.
Yeah.
Just want to re-roll.
So you do slice him, probably in the mid-waist a little pretty bit, and he is bleeding, pretty bad now. Now he's looking pretty. his enthusiasm for fighting is not there anymore.
When do you start doing bleeding damage?
we don't have the bleeding effect. So it's
I'm using it as a signal to try to you can see how his reaction versus his hit points.
Yes. But when they crush their skull, it doesn't actually crush their skull.
Trying to flavor that. It's a ringing sound in his head. It's like it feels like a crushing skull pain, like a migraine.
I thought he died. I was like, so he's dead. All right.
It's quite likely that he's going to in this turn. If he doesn't move away from the fireball, he's going to take that. If he tries to move, Sophia is going to cut his head off.
No.
You good, Sophia?
What about me? It could be me that cuts his head off.
Yeah, because no matter what direction he goes to get more than 5 feet away from it, it's going to be 2 attacks of opportunity then.
2 attacks.
Yeah. No, wait, I'm mad. So, are you going to take the damage from the fireball if you don't move?
Sophia, you got to make a dex save.
Sophia does.
Dex.
Yeah, or dex. Move and take the opportunity attack.
Oh, that failed.
That did fail.
Ah!
All right, I'll roll
I'm
it.
I'm taking you with me!
10.
10 fire damage.
I'll take it.
As you burn yourself... He's laughing. How do you like it?
How do you like it?
As my favorite Christmas vacation quote goes, smells like fried cat. Okay.
My attack?
I'm
I mean, turn.
Imag.
My attacks.
That thing had 9 lives, but you spent it all. Okay.
All right. We got a...
What's Imag up his sleeve?
What am I even holding? I'm holding my hunting bow.
Bow, I think. Your bow. You dropped your...
I did. It is on the ground winners. At my feet.
Yep. Yep.
Not prone. I'll shoot him from 5 feet away.
Disadvantage. I mean, disadvantage.
Well, it'll be regular because he's already flanked, so.
Yeah.
Okay. That's true. Ooh, 23. Nice.
23?
Yeah. Point blank in the gut.
Okay. For max damage.
Define max.
12.
I can't see it.
Show?
Oh, there it is.
There it goes. That took
ooh.
Year.
So as he was dodging Sophia, gets sliced in the fireball, you kind of snuck in a gut shot with an arrow point blank through him. With that, it took the wind out of him.
Did he shoot him in the gut and then pull the arrow from the other side instantly?
We'll see.
That'd be cool.
We'll see.
Okay.
So he hunched over with that one, and he's holding his side, even though he's got a sword. He's kind of like, oh.
Okay.
So how's that one feel?
I mean, I can see the action sequence now. He gets shot with
the arrow. Your chance, Neela, if you want to yell at him again.
Grabs the arrowhead, pulls
well,
through, and then shoots him again with the
I
same arrow.
I get another attack. Yeah. All right, I'll just...
Neela, by the way, has given up on trying to get you guys
to okay, so I just shoot him in the stomach.
who is bleeding out. I'll put that factor in there because it was a point blank through the stomach.
27, nice.
Dude, you could have been pointing at his head and hit him with that.
Fine, I hit him in the head. I'm 5 feet away. I could hit him in
so,
the head.
If you're still on your knee, you want to aim for his head? Because
you
made contact. With this head, with a bow and arrow at point blank range. How's this gonna play out? Sophia's about to get some liquefied.
The arrow goes all the way through but stops in his head, spraying the whole back of his head off. I'm gonna guess. We're gonna assume that. I'm gonna roll.
Let's see what the damage is. You could have just nicked his ear.
Oh, I could have just nicked his ear, but it's 9.
Nah, you put it right through the eyeball with. And yes, it blows out on Sophia.
It's okay. She's still covered from spider goo.
As he collapses dead.
All right. Now I say, send the fireball down the hallway.
Collapses into a ball of fire. And that is the end of combat. You guys beat the big boss and his minions.
Sweet.
Can we send the fireball down the hallway that's covered in webs?
Oh, the fireball can only move 30 feet, but
that's in combat, so it can
if
do
you,
30
if
feet.
If you want,
all right.
So, if you want, I can cast fire bolt down the hallway. That's good for 120 or 240 feet.
How about before you get rid of it?
We'll burn out all the webs.
I want it to burn out all the webs.
As I say, before you get rid of it, when you can mop up the floor with it.
Yeah. So go ahead and do that. And I didn't think about it until after I had cast it. I could have cast it, and since I cast it at a third level, earliest is second level, it counts as magical light that could have completely nullified the darkness spells.
Oh, jeez.
And killed all the spider webs and done everything.
We know for next time.
Yeah. I didn't think about it. We could have seen everything from the get-go.
That's all right. We did fine.
That's funny.
Yeah, really good.
Yeah, we did. No one died. No one went down.
Nope.
I mean, I almost did, and I
so
had half health. But
who's
I
think, now? Here's a question: damage. Who is currently hurt?
Imag.
Imag.
Okay.
Who's currently hurt? Imag. Everybody.
Okay.
Yeah, I kind of went out right.
How much time
was
left
on
life? you don't have.
Well, he was everybody kind of the one dealing. To
heal up and loot stuff up.
Yeah.
You know, okay, I'm pointing my health. Ball of fire, you know, to roll around and clean out any webs and stuff that's left in this room, and then I'm gonna point it down, you know, this hallway.
Yeah. That's fair.
How do I? Let's see. Actions.
Just do your best.
I'm just gonna like sit on Colt's back, like a very disapproving master.
King,
King's back.
Arms crossed.
I have a healing potion too in my own pocket. I can probably take unless we're like long resting it here, which I don't think we are.
Wait, nope. How hurt are you?
I could take a short rest.
He's missing 50, right?
Yeah, I'm missing 50.
So I'm gonna channel preserve life and heal you 25.
If you guys want a long rest, we can huddle up here where the sleeping bags are, and I can cast Tiny Hut.
So what's the how much would he heal up from long rest?
Oh.
All the way.
All the way? Well, there's no point there. Okay, if you guys want to do a long rest, that's fine with me.
And then we all like get our skull shots back.
That's fine.
I
want
to search the spider.
Search the spider. What's he got? What you got?
What you got?
Real quick. Real quick.
Okay, in the future, someone has to play like a chaotic evil and literally skin everything
about?
And wears it as body suits.
What are you talking about? Imag basically does that.
Yeah, but he stays away from like humanoids at least.
I do stay away from humanoids.
I saw a meme today.
The doppelganger.
I saw a meme today that it was going down after they cleared a dungeon. The druid wanted to make it into a tree loving place or something like that. Like what we do with the dungeon when we're done clearing it. And it made me think of it. Imag's gonna go around skinning everything. Druid wants to make a tree farm out of it. The wizard wants to make a college library out of it. And the bard was trying to burn it down. I said, "Well, Imag's going around skinning everything." That's it. So it is a soft cutoff point. Fair enough. So you guys are gonna do a long rest. And I'm assuming real quick before you do end the session for tonight, you do want to search the botte.
We want to search the bodies and the room.
In the room, you said there were a bunch of sleeping bags around the statue and stuff.
Well, Alan, just saying, I get dibs on the statue's eyes.
So let's yeah. See, so
good luck getting up there, Shorty.
Mm-hmm. So
athletic as heck.
So it is a big room that's laid out. There's six cracked marble pillars throughout the wall that you kind of got just now since you can see with the darkness going away. And there is a desk that sits kind of right here. It ain't marked on the map, but it's right about here. And you do see a 9-foot-tall statue of a dwarf seated on a throne with a mighty stone hammer across his lap. Large emeralds gleam in the statue's eyes.
Yep.
Okay, so... What are we doing for this?
Those are my dwarven.
What did you say? What did you say was right here? A large what?
A desk.
A desk with papers and notes and stuff like that. So okay. Right in this corner is bedrolls, general adventure gear, pickaxes and stuff like that. Nothing really value. It's just kind of like the miners that were here under Gundren. Was shoved to the side when Nazir the Black Spider made this as basically his office.
Okay.
And you get it just from the papers on the desk. It does show maps, general notes. He does mention a wraith mage from times past that was protecting the forge of spells. And you do have a gist of where that is in the map that you have drawn.
Okay.
I'm just getting a way to translate that to you. But it's to the east, about midway of the map.
Okay.
Yeah.
Can we investigate the desk further, or is that pretty much it?
That's pretty much it. Okay. Yeah, you just kind of through there. It's just shit. It's notes. So how I was gonna play that is, I will probably give you information as you come to something that he had notes on.
All right. So I guess I'll collect all the paperwork and everything that's here, and I'll put it in my bag.
I was thinking about doing a map and drawing. Like he'll know where the Forge of Souls would be, the Forge of Spells would be, and he knows where the Well, that's the forge part, but the actual mining part would be with the windmill. There's a wheel and stuff, and what other dangers he had in play that was stopping him. He talks about a wraith mage. He talks about animated zombies and skeletons from the previous battle of the war, and he has notes about the battle that happened here. I think described it in the adventure opening about what happened here with the humans and wizards and stuff that clashed here with dwarves and created and basically collapsed the entire mine within itself.
Right. So. Okay. Yeah, I'll collect all that so that I can read through it while we're resting and stuff like that.
Okay. And Sophia and Imag is looting, basically picking up a potion of healing. You can see what it is. He also has a staff. Top is black. It's made out of an animaniite that you can tell. The staff is shaped like a spider. Well, that's kind of odd being a staff, but it's shaped like a spider. Let's say it has a spider head on it. It roughly weighs about 6 pounds. And you can tell it's very magical. You just, at this point, don't know what type of magic.
Okay.
Can I investigate that staff at all?
Yeah.
Give me Arcane. Give me Arcane.
Okay, it's not that good, so hopefully.
You're about 10.
Can I roll it too?
Roll the 10.
Nice. About 10. Roll the 10.
So, you know this is a pretty powerful staff. You need to be attuned to it. Given the fact it's a spider staff, it's coming from Drow, it probably has standard features. You'll probably know more once you attune to it. As I did away with my information. It does have 10 charges and it has 2 spells.
All right. I asked the group if I can have that staff.
Sure. Yeah.
Certainly.
Okay.
And then I look over at Kendroth and be like, he didn't get his at Walmart.
Okay. And what are you rolling there, Farrah?
I'm trying to climb the statue.
Can't wait until I can cast silence on Neela.
Please.
And then in my head, I go.
Okay. So you climb up there, and you notice that there's jewel or green?
Emeralds. Two emeralds.
Two emeralds. Two emeralds.
I just want to pluck them out and take a look at them.
As you pull out the eye, everybody in the room, make me a dexterity saving throw at the 15 is your number.
Nice.
Oh, nice.
Thanks.
Before the long rest. Awesome.
Nil fails.
I fail.
Imag makes it. Remember your numbers.
11.
What do you got to make it?
Dex save of 15.
All right, so anybody that fails takes 27. You are now prone. Anybody that fails or are made to save is half damage, and you're not prone.
How's that? 13?
Oof. 27, huh?
How much was the full damage?
So it'd be 14 20, for half.
27. So as he pulls the stone out, the it was a magical trap. The pillars, 6 of them, crack, crumble, and collapse, and the whole ceiling collapses down.
We're dead?
No, we're fine. Well,
did you? Did 20?
We're trapped under the ceiling.
Did 27
did you
kill you?
Damage over?
No.
Hey, you still got 53?
No, I don't. I haven't changed it yet.
Oh, that's weird. It's not updating my.
Yeah.
It didn't do that last time, did it?
Yeah.
Something changed. Something updated.
Oh, check your D&D Beyond extension because they basically disabled it because there was an update that you had to approve to get to authorization. Just FYI.
Okay.
Mine's set up, right? Right?
Ouch, that hurt.
Yeah. But you have health. Yeah, some people are doing it. It's not about seeing it, it's about updating.
Mine updated. But I had to hit the damage button.
Yeah, but I mean, I see it, like, change.
So the emerald itself Tuning doesn't give me a call swarm.
I want to look at them like up close to find out what kind of.
Okay, so they're green emerald jewels. And if you had to put a price to it, top of my head, let's just say 20. Doesn't really say.
20 goals, you said?
Yeah.
I just want to put in there that based upon this, I'm going to turn to him and I'm going to call him a moron.
Be quiet, boy.
You
healed me first, or I would have died.
I apologize, Kendrell. There, when you investigate the table more, as you got in the papers, you happen to notice a sack, a small sack.
Okay,
let's see. It's not.
Now, was that per eye?
Oh, there we go. Mm-hmm. Update VTT token. Okay.
You do that again, I'm leaving this room. You leave the other one in there.
I can't leave my heritage behind.
Working I will now. Shoot you. I can definitely do it from here.
I will pull out my crossbow and be like, I'll shoot you too.
I'll point my wand of magic missile at you.
I'm looking both ways. Everybody is targeting me. I'm like,
No joke, we'll kill me.
Your heritage is being you're lost. Your cousins are coming in here. You're just being greedy.
That's what dwarves are.
So you said a small sack?
Small sack, yeah.
What about a small sack?
PG-13. My construction worker self is coming out, but PG-13.
PG-13. I held it in too, don't worry.
It's funny.
Just to roll it out real quick, I can make you do a bunch of checks. The other jewel is not trapped. There was only one trapped. You can take that. It's just note, it's top of my head because it doesn't give me the value. It's 20 gold piece each per emerald. There is a small, like a coin sack sitting on the desk. It has roughly 190 EP, 130 gold, 15 platinum, and 9 small gemstones, quote unquote, each worth 10 gold. And a very, very, very well made dwarven ale mug made of hammered electrum.
Wow, emerald. It says here in the thingy, it says emeralds are worth 1,000.
He said you have two. He said you have and everything of them. Two emeralds worth 20 gold each.
Yeah,
is what he said.
I'm changing it.
To be fair, I was going on top of my head. I was going to look later and probably adjust you because I don't have the information.
Cost override 20.
Yeah. So, real quick, just side note so I don't have to look it back up later. Whoever picks up the nice dwarven ale mug made of hammered electrum is worth gold pieces, no traps.
I missed that. You cut out. How many gold pieces?
100 gold pieces for the dwarven ale mug, but it's made of hammered electrum.
Who's stealing my heritage?
Where was it at? Should have on that. The desk?
It was in the desk that I was investigating, in the sack.
Oh, yeah. Well, you're flipping through the papers. We'll say that I saw it, and I'll take it.
Yeah, of course.
I'm the one that said I was investigating the desk.
I am standing literally right next to you.
After I said I was investigating the desk.
Once Neela steals it from...
I'll swat your hand away.
You'll be climbing up the statue, so...
Yeah, you're in the statue.
This all happened while you're up the statue.
You collapsed the ceiling on us.
If he tries to, like, slap my hands, I'm gonna, like... quickly grab at it.
Okay.
Whatever. You want it, take it. Whatever.
I was going to do the sleight of hand.
What else? Is there anything else on the spider? Sorry. Either way.
Negative.
There's just the staff. Okay.
A potion healing staff.
Oh.
Yeah.
Might I drink this potion? Were you resting?
We're definitely resting now that I'm down into the single digits.
Okay, yes, so exactly. I'm just gonna take this healing potion. Is that okay? I'm not gonna use it. I'm just gonna put it in my
bag. Fine with me.
That's fine.
You can have it.
Okay, I'm gonna do that then. Okay. As I remember how to do that, will be great. Manage women.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm trying to read. There's a lot of information. The Czar.
Oh, you sound like a hardcore robot.
Something.
We are not.
Yeah, you're really. We're losing you, buddy.
Add one. Say add now. It's in like the wrong end of my monitor.
Oh, I think we lost you, Avalar.
Yeah, man.
We lost Avalar. Can you hear me, auto-tune?
That was pretty much it.
You and T-Pain.
Yeah, Avalar, maybe disconnect to Discord might help that.
I think he's gone.
He's gone.
We've lost him, everybody.
Can you hear me now?
Like there you are.
You're good now, buddy.
Woo, I get through that. I hope my stream's still up, but I'll quickly spit this out real quick because I lost my notes. Everything crashed. I was trying to read through a bunch of information. I was trying to find the values of the emeralds, but I was wrong. There is another thing on Nazir. This Nazar. N-E-Z-Z-N-A-R. He carries an iron key with a head shaped like an anvil.
Ooh, okay. I definitely picked that up.
What? Why are people finding? Why are people taking away my heritage?
You're the one that wanted to climb up the statue and steal the eyes.
Yeah.
Well, don't take the eyes because they belong to the dwarves. Make sure none of the.
But the party killed the guy, so it belongs to the party.
I guess.
I mean, you can fight me for it, but...
I know what everybody collected, though. That's the only thing. You're up there focusing on, you know, not falling down and, you know, getting these emeralds while, you know, we're all checking.
It's not very far fall. It's only about 3 feet.
You merely...
No, Dom. Nobody's dead. Yet.
The statue's only 10 feet tall.
Yet. I saw you take that 27 damage. You ain't taking these from me. Does...
All right,
I feel like
he should
have taken falling damage too, but hey.
No, because the statue's only 9 feet, so it's yeah,
plus
the
and statue. And he's only like four. I mean, that's like...
Yeah, statue, but you don't.
Statue
you,
was.
I know.
D&D, you only take fall damage over 10 feet, so.
That the statue was sitting, so he took
two and a half blocks. Everything he hurt was his pride.
Does any, right, so, anything come special of this key that I can feel from it or any knowledge of it?
It's a key with the head of an anvil.
Give me a...
He has that noble
give me
insight.
I do.
Isn't there something? Don't you have a thing you can do? It's like know the location of objects or something crazy like that?
Not that I'm something. Aware of.
All right, fine.
Give me a... Give me an intelligence check. Just general... Intelligence check.
History check.
I was thinking history, but he doesn't really know. Too. But he won't know the history of this place.
Okay.
Only what was told, because it's been hidden for so long. I was thinking that. But I'm just going to base on, like, if you will, wisdom or intelligence, but he beat a 10 anyway. So you can get an idea that this probably is a key to a locked door in this cave.
Oh.
It was something that he was holding different... No, basically precious to him. Because it has an anvil on the end, you're relating it to the dwarves. This is a dwarven mine. It's probably something locked somewhere in this complex.
Can I don't know, rough shot, but can I check the statue for any markings for like a keyhole? I feel like that'd be a good spot.
Personally. I mean, you give me perception.
Well, while all this goes on, I'm going to be crawling towards this, you know, hallway.
Yeah, how what kind of shape is the room in now that the ceiling collapsed? Like, are any of the entrances blocked or like?
I won't be that rough with you. No, it's still pretty open. Rubble kind of came down and crashed with the pillars, so it's everywhere. But your exit to your to the east there, and the doors is still attainable. And all you got now is the 20-foot ceiling collapse. It's just, you see basically a hewed out like cavern ceiling, essentially.
Okay.
So,
all
right. I see Sophia looking around. I'm just gonna go over and help.
In the tool pile here, what did you say was here? Like pickaxes and stuff like that?
General mining adventuring gear. No, you're starting to notice a step that leads down.
Yeah, I'm not turning any further and stuff like that. And all
you
the
also hear
by the the giant
I want to mention to Nil as I'm following him creepily. Mm-hmm. Where's Nundro? Where's Gundren's brother?
So, there is a door to the left.
Are we gonna sleep long rest?
King is starting to pick up a scent, familiar scent.
Yeah, I was gonna take a long rest in this hallway.
Mm-hmm. In the hallway.
Why is everybody following us? This is our
secret
tryst over
Sophia
here. Go away.
Search.
Yeah. Anyway, I guess
in this hallway.
I'm gonna grab a shovel and a pickaxe to put in the bag of holding just in case.
And is King gonna watch everything?
He's he's starting to pick up a scent, a familiar scent. Not like a like he's threatened or dogs react when there's trouble nearby. No, he's picking up a familiar and he's scratching at the door right here.
All right. Well, I guess I'm gonna stand up and come to the door. I'm assuming the door's closed.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm going to try to listen in to see if I can hear anything on the other side of the door.
Yeah, so you're hearing shallow breathing.
Okay. I'm going to telepathically tell Nila what I'm hearing. And before I do anything else...
Mm-hmm.
One second here.
Neela happens to notice that there's a keyhole.
Is the door locked, though?
Okay. I'm using my staff, to give myself that healing because I need it before I attempt anything.
Okay. While he's doing that, I'm going to search the door for traps.
Okay. Go ahead and roll. I believe it's sleight of hand, I believe, is it? Perception? It's perception. Or insight.
I don't remember. What was it?
That was perception, because insight isn't insight like if someone's trying to lie to you or
That's
something?
Correct. You're correct. It's perception.
Yes.
It used to be an actual ability called check for traps. That's what.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because it's like a little bit of dexterity.
It was almost a natural 20. It was cocked. It was almost a natural 20.
Sure it was.
It's still 10. Nothing looks out of the ordinary for anything to be trapped. You're looking around, it's nothing.
All right, and I noticed the keyhole. I'm going to try to see if I can, open it. Not, shove it open, but try to, turn it and see if I can push the door open.
Okay. Yeah, so the handle's locked.
Okay.
So, no.
All right. I'm going to come back over here. And kind of, say in there, I don't need to yell, but just ask if anybody's found the key. There's a locked door over here, and it sounds like there's someone in there. He's breathing. Doesn't sound like he's in the best of, conditions. Has anybody found the key?
Hey, I have a key right here. As she's, poking out of the statue.
Well, we want to bring it over here and see if it'll unlock this door?
Yeah, I'll try to unlock it.
And I point to the door right here.
Oh, is it on your side?
Oh, no, it's right across me. I left the space open so you could...
Oh, gotcha. Sorry. All right, I'll try to unlock the door.
All right, so you put the key in and click, it unlocks.
Ooh, how about that?
I slowly open it.
Fancy.
Creak as the heavy door opens up.
Nungan!
Undro?
Exactly. So as you look in, Dusty, am I looking around? Yeah, dusty draperies adorn the walls of this room, which also contains a bed and a fire brazier over here. And a Bally the Shell dwarf lies bound and unconscious on the cold stone floor. He's been beaten and cut and tortured all kinds of ways. By looking around, you get an idea. This is kind of like the old priest's, since it's a temple as well, what's the steward and statue is kind of an old priest's room that's been turned into a holding cell, essentially.
And he looks pretty beaten up.
he's tore up pretty bad.
I heal him back up 25.
Okay.
And with I'm gonna untie him and everything. I know he's unconscious and stuff, but you know, get him so he's not bound anymore.
Yep, so he wakes up, and before we get into any farther, I think it's time for us to end the session for the night.
Yep. Okay. So what do you guys want to do? You want to take a long rest in that room? Do you want
me to say yeah? Yeah, I say, you know, after we talk with Nunjo, that's when we take a long rest in here.
Okay.
Yeah. Well, go in there and it gets dark.
Yeah.
Get off the bed, Nunjo. In my bed now.
Sophia kicks everybody out. Watch.
Anybody tired of these fighters on our group? Golly.
Does this door open in or out?
It opened. It will probably open out.
Tired of watching.
Okay. So. So Dom says, "Settle down, kids."
I will put some thread with a bell on it on the door.
Well, all right. If we all get together, I can cast Tiny Hut.
Well, yeah. Yep.
Okay, and I walk over to Nil, like, I'm ready.
So now here's the thing. I can cast it right at the doorway so that no one can enter the room.
That's how we should do it, yes.
Alright, so we just need to be within 10 feet and I'll cast Tiny Hut at the doorway.
Just you need to be within
no,
10 feet.
We all it's a ten foot dome.
Right. But you'll be closing off the door, so if I stand over here, it won't.
Oh, matter. That's true. You guys don't need to be in the dome. I can just cast it around myself. Sure, certainly. Nobody can pass through the dome. Sure.
Yeah. So we have the whole room.
You have the whole room. So I'll just cast. I'll just cast it on myself.
Cool, because I went to bed.
Sophia takes the bed.
Can you push Nundra off? Because she kind of like just nudges him off. She doesn't feel bad.
Rolling damage for taking the bed. There's like bed bugs.
No.
D12 no. Bed bugs.
Nope. All right. So who's taking watch?
I'm going to watch. I'm going to sit.
I thought we were going to cut it off. Are we going to cut it off after the long rest, I guess?
Yeah, we're going to long rest, and I want to know who's watching to plan for next session.
All right. I'll watch. I'll watch first.
I got first watch. Let's say four watches.
I'll take second, I guess.
Okay. Third?
Don't all jump up now.
I'll take one.
Sophia's asleep,
I'll take second watch as well, so Nil and Nila will take second watch. Halfling can have their alone time.
I'll take fourth.
Gotcha, okay. So Nila and Nil is taking second, and Ferris taking the fourth. Okay. All right. So with that, we'll end the session for this episode. Guys, you did beat the big boss.
It's awesome.
You haven't cleared the dungeon yet, but you just beat the big boss of Lost Mine. So technically, it's almost finished. Woo-hoo! You basically beat the big baddie.
We don't like become level 6, right?
So
because we're long rested. Because we're long rested right now. So you'd get the level 6. I'm kidding.
So let's go ahead and hand out 1,200 experience points for all that battle. But I'll be honest with you, I'm going to hold you back from going to 6 just until the first quest.
I wasn't expecting to get all of
them. Yeah. I want to hold you back probably just before you get to 6. Just until we can get out of the Dragon Ice Spire first level, because I did my math wrong. I thought this cool. start. I thought Wave Echo K started at 5. No, it started at 4, and you finished at 5. Yeah. So it messed me up. That being said, if you push it over, I'll think about it. I can always redo the CRs of that of that run. It's okay. So.
What's like what too long right now? I want to make sure that I'm equal. I'm right wrong. Where I'm supposed to be.
I'm at 8340. Yeah, 8340.
Okay, that's what I'm at. Wanted to make sure. And then also, I'm going to state it right now. While we are long resting and everything, I will also be attuning to the spider staff.
Okay. All right.
I did add it to my inventory and everything.
All right. So technically, you are just entering your long rest. Just FYI.
Yeah.
So don't heal.
No. I didn't heal yet.
I'm saying that to everybody. Yep. Don't heal.
I don't get to heal, and I am healed.
Yeah. It's just
only got my 40.
There is, so I'll just say this: there is a wandering monster table, and it rolled bad. So, FYI. Oh,
for you or for us?
For you. So,
can you make it through a hut?
It's a wandering encounter, so we'll make it gentle, but don't heal.
Don't heal.
Yeah, what's the spell that Kendron cast? I don't know about this dome or hut or whatever it is that he cast.
Yep.
Min's tiny hut. It's a 10-foot radius hut that's impenetrable, mm-hmm. except for by those in who he deems...
Yeah, only people that I allow in it can pass through it. Spells cannot pass through it. Spells right, or okay, creatures cool. that I want to keep out, magical effects cannot extend through the dome.
And okay. he can change but the I, color
but,
of the
but
dome.
But I can cast spells out of it.
Oh, that's cool.
Yep. So did you cast that?
Yes. I cast it up against the door so that nothing can enter the room.
Okay.
So I'm, you know,
what's
it's
the duration of the spell?
8 hours.
Oh, okay, cool.
He just has to stay in the center.
I just have to stay in the dome for 8 hours.
Okay. Well, with that, you probably could go ahead and heal then.
And the dome is opaque through. From the outside mm-hmm. and transparent from the inside.
Yeah, I cool. believe you can change the opaque. However you want.
Yeah, you can change the color however you want to do it.
So it could be clear if you wanted it to be.
Could be. Yep, possibly. Yep.
With that, I want to go ahead and get my end screen going. Thank Dom. Dom's been hanging out for the entire thing.
Yeah, Dom, thanks for coming out.
Thanks, man.
All right, so you said we can't heal up for a long rest because we have that dome spell up?
Yes.
Yeah, I'll play a different way, but you guys are going to get a full night's sleep with that. So.
All right, cool.
But I'll play a different way. What that, guys, man?
There's 10 monsters waiting for you outside.
That's it.
I know we got a whole cave to do, but and there's some tough encounters, but it's nothing like that was. So you technically beat the module, I can Yoo-hoo! Safely say. So I know Fan.
I'm done. We did what we came to do. I didn't come here to clean out no mines.
Oh,
they can do that themselves.
Snap. Oh, snap. We'll leave that to the next session. I don't get didn't want to meta too much. I'm sorry.
Nico, will you have a nice night? Will you do it for Nil? Will you do it for me? I need
you. Oof.
Dun, dun, dun.
Oh, bye, Farrah. And with that, he was gone. Bye, he blinked right out.
Boop. With that, I also need to go. You all have a fantastic
same here, guys.
Cool. Yeah. Night, guys. Bye.
All right, guys.
Everybody.
And night to everybody stream.
What are you painting or no?
So I am not. All
right, guys. That was a really fun stream actually for tonight and everything. I do want to thank everybody for stopping by. I'm going to actually go ahead and let's go ahead and visit my buddy Zeldaholic.
Ooh. I'm ending my stream because.
Going to end your stream?
I have to rapidly record a Hobby Streak video.
I hear you. You know what? I was thinking about painting for a couple hours, but I may just call it a night too. Thanks everybody for coming out. Dom, it was good seeing you. Avalar, Fortis, thanks for the subs. Guys, this is a great game. This was a great night.
Lots of fun.
Joey and Kevin, thanks for the follows, guys. It was good seeing you.
Nice.
And that's going to be it. Is there anybody to raid? Is there anybody to read?
Goodbye.
Oh, there's two dorks. Go read two dorks.
Yeah. Go watch some mini painting.
Yeah, we'll go read. We'll go read Tom. He's painting some Warhammer stuff. So, like I said, guys, thanks for coming out, and I'll see you over there.
Right, I'm back.
Yeah, we're going to read a painting stream.
Sweet.
I'm still willing to hang out for a bit. I just have to.
Yeah, let me jump on my phone. Actually,
I have to put together my airbrush and get ready to film, and then it's gonna be up late.
Bradley, hey, how are you doing? I didn't even know you streamed.
I just got to jump.
Bradley, did I? Thank you for the raid. How was the stream?